Well, now the Red Cross, as you know, is just one of many organizations helping the victims of Harvey.
Dylan Woolenhouse has been looking at all of them to figure out which one does the most bang for your buck, Dylan.
Yeah, there are a lot of them. Well, roughly $4 billion was raised for Hurricane Katrina, and it's possible with the size of Harvey and the donations, that it could eclipse that number. So who's getting to take care of that task to distribute all that money? It's more of a team effort rather than any one person.
The images, the stories, the emotion, you don't have to be there to feel it. Harvey has taken what it will. Now it's up to the spirit of giving to help, and millions have already.
So we've started a fundraising site, and I'm asking you to donate.
The Minnesota Twins started a fundraiser via You Caring to help Harvey victims.
My focus is very much on getting this money directly back to the people.
Houston Texans defensive end J.J. Watt also is asking for money through You Caring. He's helped raise more than $11 million. The American Red Cross, Salvation Army, Save the Children. There are countless organizations and groups that are looking for donations, but how do you know where the money is going?
It all depends on the designated policy. It across the board varies wildly based on the specific organization, but you know it will be going to hurricane relief if they have that donor designation available.
Sarah Nason is with Charity Navigator, which scores charities on transparency and accountability. When charities organized as nonprofits have a designated donation drive, the funds become restricted, meaning they can only be used towards some form of relief for that event, in this case, Hurricane Harvey. On the site, charities are scored on things like administrative and program expenses, even how effective it is at spending donors' money. For example, the Houston Food Bank is able to donate 99 cents for every dollar donated.
And I know it's do your research, do your research, do your research is what you're hearing all the time now, but that's really new to avoid any scams or any bogus claims or charities that are out there.
So now, despite a massive amount of money pouring into Texas from each fundraising effort, there is no central organization that distributes or handles it. Experts in emergency management say that it is up to the donor organization or where they choose to give those funds. Now, local governments can appoint a liaison to help direct where those funds go. Money from relief, large funds may be designated to neighborhoods or housing authorities or that sort of thing. But again, those liaisons don't typically have authority on where it goes. It just says, hey, this is where it's needed.
Sounds like so much of it's based on trust, plain and simple. You go, J.J. Watt, I trust you with my money. You're
and
doing
you
a good
like
thing.
And organizations.
Yeah. Right. And it's totally how it is probably with J.J. Watt. And then as you see the celebrities come forward, Sandra Bullock, even President Trump today gave his $1 million to Harvey relief efforts. So many people doing it. It'll be fascinating to see what the tally will be. But all good things.
No doubt.
Thanks, Dylan.
We'll be right back.